we're going to do a part three. Okay. I'm Brainwash444, Heather Ann McGaugh, Blessington. Part one, I talked about Blackstone trafficking operations, primarily focused in on Extended Stay America, but also because they just bought them out, but also describing to you, because it matters, if we're going to take down trafficking, you have to understand the structure of hotels, and Blackstone owns 99% of the world. So that's what I did in part one. Part two, I went into more detail and specifically what happened to me at Extended Stay America, Blackstone Hotels, them kicking me out, and all details surrounding of how they run their operation, from freaky decor that's all black magic. I contend Extended Stay Americas are like death centers, okay? So I go into detail and all that, part one, part two. Part two, we went into some other interesting stuff along the way, but it cut me off at the very end, and what I was finishing with is, I went in the story of, I'm getting evicted because I'm not paying because I caught them dumping into the water. People are dying. Weird shit's going down. They don't give me any due process. It was a fake hearing notice they sent me. I'm like, I'm not going. Forget that. I record a special recording for the judge so they know. I try to call the numbers they give us. The numbers don't work. I mean, this is what they do. They deny your due process. It's on purpose. Okay. So then they evict me. At the point I left off in part two was basically I'm detained, I'm cold, they're going to just leave me off. Like, just there, go start walking. So they bring to me, I say, bring me a sweatshirt or whatever, I'm going to be freezing. So they bring me a bright green, neon green sweatshirt and a pink scarf. It was deliberate, okay? It was my daughter's tennis sweatshirt from Eisenhower High School. It was green. And the scarf was pink because that's an MK Ultra color, okay? Another one is, it's like the blue-purple. So blue-purple you saw in the inauguration. Remember how they were wearing those outfits? It was blue. No, it was turquoise, magenta. That color scheme they had going on. All the ladies wore those colors. That's it, okay? And then there's a pink green. It's the preppy. If you remember the preppy handbook from the 80s or 90s, that's the colors. And it launched this whole country club Whiteyville preppy handbook, okay? Lady Gaga is pink green. Like, it's like the people they tortured. It's like the people they secretly stalked and bloodline tortured their whole life. I'm in that club. So anyway, for the cop to deliver that as my outfit to leave is not random. Okay, so here's the end. Picture this. I'm 52 disabled woman. You denied me due process with a fake hearing, so now you evicted me on my parents' my mother's birthday with the name of the law firm Amundsen, which was my dad's Air American family handler. So I'm walking out with the paperwork. I'm going, you've just packed up all my shit. I'm now broke as a joke because you're hunting me and on the run, and I've spent all my 401k money in the past year trying to stay alive. So now I have to pay $1,000, whatever it is, to go get my car a half hour away in the ghetto of Milwaukee at Eagle Moving and Storage, only to find you stole $5,000 worth of stuff, you broke my eyeglasses, you stole my precious necklace, and you urinated on my precious things for my children. Okay. So, here I am. I'm still at extended stay. I'm in the truck. They're releasing me from being detained. Okay? I don't know yet all the shit they've done to my stuff. All I know is all my stuff's gone, and they're sending me, and it's cold, and I'm in Wisconsin, and I'm walking away with this now green sweatshirt on with a pink scarf. And there's five cop, like, SUVs parked on extended stay like this on the driveway. It's like a hill that goes down. It's all the way up and down. They're like this, parked, watching me walk away. And I have two friends. One can't come get me because, you know, her husband would freak. Because no one can talk to Heather because it's dangerous. We got to protect herself, even though she's walking alone, now lost everything again. And we, no, not her fault. These people are powerful. And then I called another friend, suddenly working. So I'm someone who was a business leader, Girl Scout leader, raised everybody's kids. My house was the party house, figuratively. My house was the safe house where all the kids hung out, and then I took care of everybody in a little cute above ground pool, and everybody hung out, and they knew they were safe there with Mrs. Blessington. And so the community of Weatherstone and New Berlin and Waukesha County, the fact that you have all watched this for 2 years is just beyond. And I don't talk to anybody. Nobody talks to me from that town. They chased me out by beaming me with an energy weapon in my bedroom before COVID started. I told you this whole story already. That was 2019. Subsequently, a year later, Joseph Garza, the warlock from Hell Superintendent, with Judge Affertamian of Waukesha County. These are the characters that pulled the parade. These are the characters that are running all this black magic, okay? They're doing this shit over here. They're beaming Heather in her bedroom, and they beamed Amy Crosby, I contend, with an energy weapon. And she's one of my best friends in the world that helped raise my kids. She's the president of the school board. And you're telling me, New Berlin, you're going to allow that 400-pound satanic Luciferian warlock walk our children to their Burghardt grave because you don't have the guts to stand up? You're all sick. And the people that survive, we're going to emancipate your children from you because you're incompetent. And to my ex, you're lucky our kids are adults. Because what you've done sitting there hiding, you're all hiding. It's just... the level of disappointment I feel in my family, my children too. I don't want to say it to them because you want to pump your kids out. I just... kids, for you now too, you're both adults. You're watching. What are you thinking? What are you thinking they did to Mrs. Crosby? What are the adults in your life telling you? Yo, it's not safe. We're going to keep you safe. Stay away from mom. She's in danger. You're in danger because you're not engaging with me. Your father's incompetent. Your grandparents are incompetent. Your aunt and uncle are incompetent. All they did is dance around you and tell you that I'm insane. And your Aunt Chris was busy taking you, Grace, off on Mother's Day away from me. This was a woman that was like my sister. Like, I nursed her through breast cancer. I helped her win a case that she didn't even have to go to court. Really? Shall we tell this story, Christine? Are you enjoying your money, Christine? This is how you don't need court. This is why you work with someone like Heather. Because when you go to the doctor and you're like Christine Rademacher and you're very thin and you have a tumor protruding out of your bra that you can see through your tight t-shirt, that it's that big. And when your doctor at Summit Hospital, the gold hospital, the one with the gold elevators, when they won't do a mammogram for Christine, when she has a tumor that's sticking out of the side of her shirt, you can see it. It's called malpractice. And when that person goes down with triple negative breast cancer and almost dies in her 40s, it's called malpractice. So you don't go to court. You don't sit around and whine. You work with Heather and a PR firm. And you send a letter to the head of the Aurora Hospital. And you give the president 24 hours to respond. And you tell them, if you don't respond in 24 hours, I'm going to WTMJ News. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to explain to us why Christine didn't have a mammogram. And you know what happened? Ring. Hello? Yes, it's Heather. Yes, we'd be happy to meet with you. When? Where? We proceeded into the gold hospital, and Christine and her husband, and me and my husband, took the gold elevator upstairs. And there we found the president of Aurora Hospital, the pathologist, the radiologist, the nurse, everyone who was touched this case, around a U-shaped table, waiting for us. They went around and gave us their testimony, and then they said, how much money you want? They said, Christine, we're very sorry. We changed our protocols. We should have given you a mammogram. How much money you want? Christine, I told you to go for over $1 million. No, did you listen? $200,000. They handed it to you and laughed. And then you took your $200,000. La-di-da on your way. Why don't you use some of that $200,000 if you still have any? I hope you're using it to take care of my children.
You're going to use some of that money, Christine, to take care of my children that you stole? My daughter that you stole her brain over here? Because you think you're smarter? These are good people that will not listen. Christine, you work at a restaurant owned by the whale. You grew up in New Berlin and went to Holy Apostles. They shattered your brother Jimmy, who I married and loved. Jimmy had a walk-in. There's so much black magic shit going on, and you don't care because you're getting ready for the Packer party. So, Christine, I'm telling you right now, Christmas is canceled, and you're going to get your shit together. And I'm going to keep calling you out because what you did to me on Mother's Day in the height of this is sick. And then when our whole life fell apart and you followed your brother's insane narrative about me and our whole life fell apart, what did you do? You came over with your sunglasses. This woman, my former sister-in-law that was like, I would have given my life to, stood there with sunglasses on, chewing gum on her phone, would not look at me. Because, you know, I'm a paranoid, schizophrenic, drug addict in a cult. Christine, you're the reason I end up in the psych ward. Because you're so freaking stupid. Christine went to school for social work, and then she recommended that I call Waukesha County. Because we're having money problems after the divorce that she helped facilitate, and I wanted to go to counseling. So she suggested I call the hotline, Christine. And that's what I did. This was before I got beamed with an Andrew Rep, and this is well before all this other shit, but I guess we're going here. I have not called this woman out, and I'm calling you this woman because I don't even know you anymore. All this. I've shown tremendous restraint, so if my family's sitting here, oh my God, you're next. Should have called all of you out long ago, a bunch of sickos. You think you're going to sit around and have Packer parties and fill your face for Christmas? You think that's what you're going to do with my kids in tow? Nope. Who do you think you are? Who do you think you are? Daniel Rademacher, Christine Rademacher. Who do you think you are? You busy getting your boosters, Christine? I told Benny it's going to kill your mother. You're over there on Facebook talking about shots, liking my daughter's posts. This is what they got my daughter doing over there. Grace Ann, you posted, if you're seeing the signs of paranoid schizophrenia in a loved one. My daughter post said, there's Christine and all the aunts. Oh, the coven of aunts. Oh, Gracie, we love you. Oh, we're such good people supporting the Blessington kids while Heather goes off on a bender. Now what do you do, Christine? Out there in Lake Country? Am I dangerous? Are you telling the kids, we're going to keep you protected? Your mom's in danger. You're in dangerous territory. How you sleeping? Thought so. From this day forward, my family, this shit's going to get serious. If you think I've been serious up to this point, I haven't. I want my kids' brains back. This world needs Grace Ann Blessington and Sydney James Blessington because they're star seeds. And those two kids are going to lead this. I'm going to go to the background because they came here to be awesome and amazing, and they're not going to be held down by losers like you who can't expand your thinking, who are blood cultists worrying about the Packers, working at a freaking restaurant owned by the Whalers. Wisconsin? What is this shithole called that she works at? Machine Shed. No, is it Machine Shed? Thunder Bay. What are they cooking at Thunder Bay, Christine? What are they cooking at Thunder Bay, Christine? Are you this dumb? Who owns Thunder Bay? All right, I'm done. This makes me so freaking pissed, you guys. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry. I had to get it out. Is there anything else that I want to say about Christine Rademacher, who will be giving me my children back and telling them all the lies that you've told? Make better choices, Christine. I did not deserve this. I did everything for you. You wouldn't have your house and your fancy kitchen and all this other shit. You think God's not watching? Fake. Jimmy's shattered over there. Thanks to holy apostles. I'm the only thing that held him together. So I can't imagine what you guys are doing to him. This is never going to end if families don't wake up and tell the truth. And if they think, the core of this is people thinking I'm dangerous because I'm talking about this. That's why this took so long to come out. That's why all these people on here are going to actually care and be like, holy shit, we could take down all this trafficking ourselves. They're giving us everything we need. All we have to do is expose them. You guys, this is never going to end. You're going to sit in your house listening to intel from people like me until they knock on your door and quarantine you. That is what is going to happen. So, I am proposing the solution is this. You call your family out like I just did. It's not fun. I don't feel good about this. I will hang up here and feel so shitty that I just did what I did. Why should I? Why do you feel shitty about what you did, watching me in the frickin' woods of Wisconsin be hunted? Beyond words. Beyond friggin' words. Guys, if you want out of your house, if you want out and you want a life again, I am here to lead. I know exactly what to friggin' do, but I need people to take action. And I want my children back. I deserve my children back. And they deserve to come back. And all these cousins are leaders. They're starseed people that are in this with these people. And they're going to walk my kids to their grave. They've already gotten the vaccines. They're doing fluoride. They're eating poison. All of it. Nothing's changed since I haven't been around. It's gotten worse. For what? So Christine and Grandma D can have Christmas? Nope. I didn't come here for that shit. Neither did any of you. Let's say a prayer. The Lord is going to help us with this with grace and ease, but I need you guys to take that first step, okay? The first step is when you go to the grocery store, whatever you're doing, just go through a hotel parking lot, extended stay. Just go see what you see. They're going to start showing you and just be brave, okay? We got to do this for the future generation or there isn't going to be one. They've pretty much sterilized all our kids. So now we got to get to them so they're not sterilized. The antidote is NanoSoma. NanoSoma. Doctors are standing by. Telegram. Okay? We have solutions. We have options now. But you have to hardcore call out the people in your life for the fakes that they are. Because this fake Stepford wife, Whiteyville, thinking they're doing Christmas shit is the problem. Okay? I want this to end. All right, breathe. In the name of Yeshua, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, White Buffalo Woman is our guide. Please shed light on the truth. Please give everyone the confidence and the ability to see the truth and say the truth. And even if they've made mistakes, realize they're going to be forgiven, but the time is now to come forward and do the right thing. For all kids that are in this MK Ultra mind control, stuck with these parents and these families that are walking them to their graves with various forms of poison, please give these kids the strength and the confidence and the energy to know that they will be safe, even safer, with people like us. And that is the road to their future. And help these kids turn away from this transhuman agenda of computers, pornography, nonsense online. It's all AI, and release them from this AI that has a grip on their brains so we can get our kids back and we can go on down the road to bigger and better things, ending this. So expose all this darkness.
I close all our auras to all but our own Christ consciousness. Tell any discarded spirits they're forgiven, healed, lifted, enlightened. Take them to their safe place. Go in peace. Everyone on this call, surround them with an aura of protection. Close their auras to all but their own Christ consciousness. Tell entities they're forgiven, healed, lifted, enlightened. Go in peace. You are protected. You always were protected. You have a whole army of guardians surrounding you. There's nothing in the universe to be afraid of. And on the physical, you have me 24/7. DM me anytime. Through any of my channels, my email is bw444@protonmail.com. Okay? I'm your resource on the ground. You might need me just to feel good. But your guardians are here. You came here for a great purpose. You are not on this call for no reason. Okay? You have a piece of my puzzle. I have a piece of yours. We are so powerful, it's freaking ridiculous. We just have to remember. Okay? And we're going to have better families than we could ever dream of. We would have never found each other if we didn't go through all this hell, right? We're here for the kids. Be brave. Go drive your ass through the extended Sam Miracle parking lot and tell me what you find. Have a good one.